Good afternoon, ma. I'm P. Kavita. I'm working as a contract lecturer in mathematics. Now I will take mathematics cluster class, that is 6th semester, paper 8A, that is unit 2, application of Laplace transform to differential equations, that is the method is application of Laplace transform to solutions of partial differential equations. Now I will share the screen. Hello, the screen is visible, ma? Hello? Hello? Please give response.
Yes, madam.
In the last class, up to 4 problems we have covered. Now, I will tell 5th problem. Question is, solve dou y by dou t is equal to 3 dou square y by dou x square, y of pi by 2 comma t equal to 0, dou y by dou x at x equal to 0, y of x comma 0 equal to 30 cos 5x. Given problem is dou y by dou t is equal to 3 into dou square y by dou x square, and y of pi by 2 comma t means y, which is in the form y of x comma t, x value is pi by 2, then that value is 0, and dou y by dou x means derivative of y with respect to x at x equal to 0, its value is also 0 given. Y of x comma 0 means y of x comma t at t equal to 0, then y of x comma 0 value is 30 cos 5x. Now we are writing the given equation, that is dou y by dou t is equal to 3 dou square y by dou x square. Now taking Laplace transform on both sides, L of dou y by dou t is equal to 3 is constant into L of dou square y by dou x square. Now, L of dou y by dou t formula is P into y bar minus y of x comma 0. P into y bar of x comma p is same as y bar. P into y bar minus y of x comma 0 is equal to 3 into L of dou square y by dou x square formula is d square y bar by dx square. Then, now we are substituting P y bar as it is minus y of x comma 0. Its value is given the 30 cos 5x. Therefore, P y bar as it is minus y of x comma 0 value is 30 cos 5x into 3 d square y bar by dx square. Now, 3 into, we are writing the right side equation, right side term as in left hand side. Then 3 d square y bar by dx square. Then left p y square comes to the right side. That is minus p y bar is comes to the right side. Minus p y bar, which is equal to right side term, left side term, that is minus 30 cos 5x as it is. Then this equation becomes 3 d square y bar by dx square minus p y bar is equal to minus 30 cos 5x. Now, d square y bar by dx square coefficient is 3. Therefore, we have to make its coefficient is 1. Therefore, we have to divide with equation with this equation, we divide this equation with 3 on both sides of that equation. Therefore, 3 d square y bar by dx square root by 3 and 3 gets cancelled. Then d square y bar by dx square root minus second term p is there. And we are dividing with 3, that is p by 3 y bar, which is equal to minus 30 cos 5x by 3. 30 by 3 means it is minus 10. That is minus 10 cos 5x. We are dividing with 3. That is minus 30 cos 5x reduces to minus 10 cos 5x. Now, d square y bar by dx square minus p by 3 y bar is equal to minus 10 cos 5x. Now, d by dx can be written as capital D. Therefore, auxiliary equation is, we are taking y bar as common. We are taking y bar as common. That is d square by dx square. D square y bar by dx square can be written as capital D square y bar. You have to put y bar there. D square y bar by dx square minus p by 3 y bar. In those two terms, we are taking off y bar common. D square by dx square capital D square of y bar we are writing. Therefore, we are taking y bar as common. Remaining term is capital D square minus p by 3, which is equal to minus 10 cos 5x. Then, which is in the form of linear differential equations with constant coefficients, that is cos ax method. Now, auxiliary equation is m square minus d square minus p by 3 f of d. Therefore, f of m we have to write, that is f of m value is m square minus p by 3, which is equal to 0. Therefore, m square equal to plus p by 3. M square equal to plus p by 3 means m equal to plus or minus root p by 3. M value is plus or minus root p by 3. Therefore, m1 is plus root p by 3 and m2 is minus root p by 3. We have got two different roots, m1 and m2. Then what are the complementary function mark? Anyone can tell? M1, M2 are plus root p by 3 and minus root p by 3 are two roots we have got. Then what is the complementary function? Anyone can tell me? Please respond. Hello? Hello? M1 is one root, that is root p by 3. M2 is minus root p by 3 ma. Then get a wrongly written pa and cf as interchangeable. Cf is a e power root p by 3x plus b e power minus root p by 3x. That is, if m1 m2 are different roots, different roots, then CF means complementary function. You have studied in first year linear differential equations with constant coefficients. So CF is C1 e power m1x plus C2 e power m2x. Here m1 is plus root p by 3, m2 is minus root p by 3. Then CF you have to write. There akkada PA is wrongly written. CF is A e power root p by 3x plus B e power minus root p by 3x. This is CF. Now, we have to calculate PI also. Here CF is wrongly written, that is PI. PI is equal to 1 by F of D value. We are substituting. F of D is capital D square minus P by 3 into right side term minus 10 cos 5x as it is. Now, 1 by D square minus P by 3 into minus 10 cos 5x is here. Now, which is in the form of cos ax method. F of d of y equal to cos ax. Then we will substitute f of d of y is cos ax. Then we will substitute d square, which is equal to minus of a square. Then f of d square value is not equal to 0. Then we will put d square in place of d square. We will put minus of a square. That is cos 5x means a value is 5. Now we are substituting d square which is equal to minus of a square, that is minus of 25 square, which is minus 25. Now we are substituting minus 25 in place of d square, which is f of cos ax method. D square place lo minus a square we are substituting minus p by 3 as it is, that is minus 10 cos 5x as it is. Now in the denominator, minus 25 minus p by 3, we are taking LCM is 3. Minus 25 into 3 means minus 75 minus p. We have to take common, minus of 75 plus p. That is 3 into minus 10 cos 5x as it is. 3 into minus 10 cos 5x is minus 30 cos 5x. So in the denominator, we have to write within brackets minus of 75 plus p, you have to write brackets. Therefore, minus minus plus, that is 30 cos 5x by 75 plus p. PI value is 30 cos 5x by 75 plus p. And CF value is A e power root p by 3x plus B e power minus root p by 3x. Wrongly typed, this is wrongly written. PI is CF, CF is PI. Now, solution is y bar equal to CF plus PI. Y bar is CF value is A e power root p by 3x plus B e power minus root p by 3x and CF. Plus PI value is 30 cos 5x by 75 plus p. Now y bar means L of y. L of y means y of x comma t. That is y of x comma t. The given conditions in this problem are y of pi by 2 comma t equal to 0. It means x value is pi by 2. Then y of pi by 2 comma t value is given, that is 0. Now we are substituting x equal to pi by 2 in y bar. X equal to pi by 2 in y bar. Y bar value is left side. Y bar means L of y, that is L of y of pi by 2 comma t equal to 0. It means we are substituting both sides in place of x, that is pi by 2. That is y of pi by 2 comma t value is left side 0, that is equal to right side a e power root p by 3 into pi by 2, x value pi by 2, plus b e power minus root p by 3 into x, x value is pi by 2, next plus 30 cos 5x undi, 30 cos pi by 2, cos pi by 2 ni, pi by 2 can be written as 2 pi plus 1 cos 5 pi by 2 avutadi. That is 2 pi plus pi by 2, it can be written as 5 pi by 2 can be written as 2 pi plus pi by 2, that is 4 pi plus 5 pi by 2. Cos 360, that is cos 2 pi plus pi by 2 means cos pi by 2 only, but cos pi by 2 and cos 180 by 2 and cos 90, cos 90 value is 0. Therefore, third term, 30 cos 5 pi by 2 term 0. It becomes 0, then equation reduces to 0 is equal to a e power root p by 3 into pi by 2 plus b e power minus root p by 3 into pi by 2. That is equation 1. Now, y bar is equal to actual equation we have again written. Y bar is equal to a e power root p by 3x plus b e power minus root p by 3x plus 30 cos 5x by 75 plus p as it is we have written. This is y bar. Now we are differentiating both sides with respect to x. Y bar derivative with respect to x means y is a function of two variables x and t. Therefore y bar means we have derivative with respect to x means we have to write dou y bar by dou x. We are differentiating this on both sides with respect to x. Already y bar we are having, then we are differentiating this with respect to s, that is dou y bar by dou x is equal to a e power root p by 3x. What is the derivative of e power ax, ma? Please respond. What is the derivative of e power ax? Anybody? Hello? Hello? E power ax derivative chepandma?
To e power ax.
Emma?
A into e power ax, ma'am.
E power ax derivative, e power ax into coefficient of x, that is a. A e power ax and the derivative of e power ax. Now, y bar is equal to a e power root p by 3 x, that is a constant as it is. E power root p by 3 x, which is in the form of e power ax form. That is a value is root p by 3 x. E power ax form, its derivative is e power a root p by 3 x into x coefficient, that is root p by 3. Therefore, y bar derivative is dou y bar by dou x value is equal to a root p by 3 into e power root p by 3 x plus b e power minus root p by 3 x term undi. B is constant to e power minus ax derivative, that is minus a into e power minus ax. In the same manner, e power minus root p by 3 x value derivative is e power minus root p by 3 x into minus root p by 3. Now we have written plus b into root p plus b into e power minus root p by 3 x into minus root p by 3. This can be written as minus of, that is dou y bar by dou x equal to a e power root p by 3 into e power root p by 3 x minus b into e power minus root p by 3 x derivative b into e power minus root p by 3 into e power minus root p by 3 x. Next, plus 30 cos 5 x by 75 plus p undi. Now we are differentiating this with respect to x. Therefore, 30 by 75 plus p is we are taking as constant. Then derivative of cos 5x, that is dou by dou x of cos 5x, means derivative of cos x is minus sin x. Therefore, cos 5x derivative is minus sin 5x into 5x derivative into 5. That is minus 30 cos 5x derivative sin 5x into 5 by 75 plus p as it is. Now, dou y bar by dou x is equal to dou y bar by dou x value we have written like this. Now, dou y bar by dou x value at x equal to 0, we have already given condition is dou y bar by dou x at x equal to 0 value is given, that is 0. Now, we are substituting on both sides x equal to 0 on both sides. X equal dou y bar by dou x equation, we are substituting both sides x equal to 0. Then dou y bar by dou x at x equal to 0 value is a e power root p by 3 into e power root p by 3 x is there. Here x value is 0, then e power root p by 3 into 0 also e power 0. But e power 0 value is 1. Therefore, a e power root p by 3 value is a e power root p by 3 into 1 value, a into root p by 3 into 1 value, that is a root p by 3 minus b into root p by 3 into e power minus root p by 3 x. We are substituting x value is 0. Therefore, e power minus 0. E power minus 0 or e power plus 0, same value, that is e power 0 value 1. Therefore, minus b into root p by 3 value is into 1, that value is equal to minus b into root p by 3. Next, third term, we are substituting x equal to 0. But minus 30 sin 5x, minus 30 sin 5x into 5. In place of x, we are substituting 0. 5 into 0 is 0, that is sine 0. But sine 0 value always 0. Therefore, third term becomes 0. Sine 0 is 0. Third term, entire third term is 0. Only remaining two terms we have got, that is dou y bar by dou x at x equal to 0 value is 0. Left side 0 now. Left side 0 is equal to a into root p by 3 minus b into root p by 3. Equal to b mundu 0 petal. Next. Put equation. Solving equations 1 and 2. One equation is మన యాక్చువల్ ఈక్వేషన్ ఎక్స్ ఈక్వల్ టు పై బై టూ సబ్స్టిట్యూట్ చేసిన ఈక్వేషన్ వై ఆఫ్ పై బై టూ కమా టీ ఈక్వల్ టు జీరో దెన్ జీరో ఈక్వల్ టు ఏ ఇంటూ రూట్ పీ బై త్రీ ఇంటూ పై బై టూ ప్లస్ బి ఇంటూ ఈ పవర్ మైనస్ రూట్ పీ బై త్రీ ఇంటూ పై బై టూ దట్ ఈస్ ఈక్వేషన్ వన్. నౌ డో వై బార్ బై డో ఎక్స్ అట్ ఎక్స్ ఈక్వల్ టు జీరో వాల్యూ ఈస్ జీరో వీ హ్యావ్ గాట్ ఈక్వేషన్ టూ దట్ ఈస్ జీరో ఈక్వల్ టు ఏ రూట్ పీ బై త్రీ మైనస్ బి రూట్ పీ బై త్రీ అని. Now solving, which is these two are equations in the form of some 2x plus 3y is equal to 0, some 4x plus 3y is equal to 0. Whatever values we will take, whatever values we have taken, then we will get which is in the form. There are two equations unnai manaki. AX, if 2x plus 3y is equal to 0, let us take which is in the form 2x plus 3y is equal to 0 or 3x plus 4y is equal to 0. Now we are solving for any two equations for x and y. We have to solve for y, then we have to make x coefficient as same one. Therefore, 2x plus 3y equal to 0 and 3x plus 2y equal to 0, then equation 1 into 3 and equation 2 into 2, we make x terms are 0, sorry, we make x terms are equal, then subtract from each other, we will get y terms equal to 0. Because right side terms equal to 0, then equations, we are solving for x, then we will get y equal to 0. Now we substitute y equal to 0 in place of any one equation, then we will get x equal to 0. In the similar manner, in equation 1, e power a y bar is equal to a e power, in equation 1, left side 0 equal to, in equation 1, left side 0 is equal to a into root p by 3 into pi by 2 of a term, which is in the form 2 capital A. E power root p by 3 into pi by 2, let us take some constant, some constant to 2 capital A plus e power minus root p by 3 into pi by 2 term is some capital B. Let us take 2 capital A plus 3 capital B. Let us take which is in the form 2a plus 3b equal to 0. Now, our equation is 0 is equal to a into root p by 3. The term is 3a minus 4b equal to 0. Now, we are solving for a and b. Then, we will make b terms are same. And we will get a 2a, no, some 3a is equal to 0. Then, a equal to 0. Now, we are solving equations 1 and 2. We can get A equal to 0 and B equal to 0. Because right side terms are, because left side terms are 0, then after solving A and B, we will get A is 0 and B is 0. It will check later. Next. A equal to 0, B equal to 0. Then, A and B values we are substituting in equation 1 in y bar. Y bar is equal to first term A is 0, then first term 0, B is 0 and second term 0. Only remaining term y bar equation is, our y bar equation is A e power root p by 3x plus B e power minus root p by 3x plus 30 cos 5x by 75 plus p. In that, a and b are zeros, we are substituting, then only third term is, that is y bar is equal to 30 cos 5x by 75 plus b only remains. Therefore, y bar value is 30 cos 5x by 75 plus p. Y bar means L of y, but L of y is equal to 30 cos 5x by 75 plus p. Now, y is equal to 30 cos 5x as take constant. L comes to the right side, L inverse of 1 by 75 plus p. Now, y is equal to 30 cos 5x constant as it is. L inverse of, which is in the form, L inverse of 1 by p plus a value is e power minus at. Now, L inverse of 1 by 75 plus p, which is in the form, L inverse of 1 by p plus 75. Therefore, a value is 75. Therefore, its value is e power minus at, but a value is e power minus 75t. L inverse of 1 by p plus a value is e power minus at. Therefore, L inverse of 1 by 75 plus p value is e power minus 75t. Therefore, answer is y equal to 30 cos 5x into e power minus 75t. This problem very, very important too. Similar way, next problem is also important. Next problem, solve dou square y by dou x square minus dou square y by dou t square is equal to x into t. Problem is, solve dou square y by dou x square minus dou square y by dou t square equal to x t when y equal to 0, dou y by dou x at x equal to 0, at t equal to 0, and y of 0 comma x equal to 0. Given conditions are this: y equal to 0 when t equal to 0 means y and y of x comma t. T equal to 0 and it y of x comma 0 value is given 0. Similarly, dou y by dou t at t equal to 0 and y dash of t at x equal to y dash of t is also 0 at t equal to 0 now. That is y means y of x comma t, y dash means y dash of x comma t. In the t 0, y dash of x comma 0 value is 0, that is given. Y dash of x comma 0 value can be written as y dash means y of t, y suffix t. That is, our given equation is dou square y by dou x square minus dou square y by dou t square. Now we are taking Laplace transform on both sides. L of dou square y by dou x square minus L of dou square y by dou t square is equal to x into x, let us take x as constant, and L of t. Now L of dou square y by dou x square minus L of dou square y by dou t square is equal to x into L of t. Now we are applying Laplace transform on both sides. Now L of dou square y by dou t square formula is L of dou square y by dou t square formula is d square y bar by dx square minus L of dou square y by dou t square formula. Already we have derived four formulas. That is p square y bar of x comma p minus y of x comma 0 minus yt of x comma 0. Manaki second formula. L of dou square y by dou t square and four formulas we have derived. That is the second one. L of dou square y by dou t square value is p square y bar of x comma p minus p of y of x comma 0 minus yt of x comma 0. Yt means dou y by dou t. That can be written as y dash of x comma 0 also. That is p square y bar of x comma p minus p into y of x comma 0 minus yt of x comma 0, which is equal to x into L of t form. L of t form, which is in the form of L of t power n, its value is n factorial by p power n plus 1. T power n is a positive integer, then L of t power n value n factorial by p power n plus 1. That is, L of t means n value is 1, that is 1 by 1 factorial by 1 by p power 1 plus 1, that is 1 by p square. Therefore, L of t value 1 by p square before x is there. Next, d square y bar by dx square as it is, minus p square y bar also as it is. Next, minus of minus plus p y of x comma 0. But y of x comma 0 value is given, that is 0. Therefore, p into y of x comma 0 value 0, p into 0 anna 0, second term 0, minus this is also given yt of x comma 0, that is yt of x comma t in t value 0, then yt of x comma 0 also given, that is dou y by dou t at x equal to z at t equal to 0 is given, its value is 0. Now we are substituting. After substituting the y of x comma 0 value is 0, yt of x comma 0 value is 0, then we have got only three terms, that is d square y bar by dx square minus p square y bar, which is equal to x by p square. Third term, fourth term, zeros, because y of x comma 0, 0, yt of x comma 0, 0 is given. Only three terms. That is d square y bar by dx square minus p square y bar is equal to x by p square. These are the terms remaining terms are these. Now, which is in the form linear differential equations with constant coefficients. Now, d square y bar by dx square can be written as capital D square y bar minus p square y bar, which is equal to x by p square. In the left hand side, we are taking y bar as common, then capital D, this step is not written here. Please guess this. D square by dx square is, that is capital D square y bar minus p square y bar. But in these two terms, we are taking y bar as common, that is capital D square minus p square of y bar is equal to right side term. Right side term x by p square. Now, auxiliary equation is m square, in place of d we will substitute m. Therefore, auxiliary equation is m square minus p square is equal to 0. M square is it, then m equal to plus or minus p. M equal to plus or minus p, that is two roots we have got, plus p and minus p. Now, if these two roots are plus p and minus p, then CF value is equal to C1 e power m1x plus C2 e power m2x we will write. But in place of auxiliary equation is C1 e power m1x. C1 e power m1x, that is A e power plus px plus B e power minus px. That is CF. CF is A e power p1x, sorry, m1x and plus px plus b e power m2x and minus px. That is CF. This is also wrongly written. CF is PA and PA is CF. Now we are calculating PI. PA is particular integral. Particular integral value is 1 by d square minus p square of x by p square, right side term on the x by p square. 1 by p square outside is sum. Right side x by p square term on number, that is 1 by d square minus p square of x by p square. 1 by p square before we will write, that is 1 by p square on the 1 by d square minus p square. In the denominator, we are taking minus p square as common. That is minus p square we are taking common. 1. D square is there, but we are taking p square is common. 1 minus d square by p square. Second term, first term, go first term, second term, go rasam. D square can be written in first term. D square is there. We are taking p square. Then this can be written as d square by p square. But minus p square we are taking common. Therefore, 1 minus d square by p square of x. Already x by p square ekka term, that is my ekkada x by p square is not written. 1 by p square to p square, that is 1 by p power 4 into in 1 by 1 minus d square p square undi. This term can be written as, it comes to the numerator. Side lo you have to write. Oka nimisham white screen teeskundam. White screen share. White board undi. Oka nimisham share chestam. Share white board. స్క్రీన్ కనపడుతుంది చూడండి, పెన్ సెలెక్ట్ చేసుకున్నాను. వన్ బై పి స్క్వేరు ఇంటూ వన్ బై డి స్క్వేరు మైనస్ పి స్క్వేరు. మాస్క్ వైట్ బోర్డ్ షేర్ అయిందా? వైట్ బోర్డ్ షేర్ అయిందమ్మా, ప్లీజ్ గివ్ రెస్పాన్స్. మ్యామ్
ఎస్ మ్యామ్ ఎస్ మ్యామ్
1 బై పి స్క్వేర్ ఈ టర్మ్ ఇదమ్మా, ఇది పిఏ ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు 1 బై పి స్క్వేర్ ఇంటూ వన్ బై డి స్క్వేర్ మైనస్ పి స్క్వేర్ ఇంటూ ఎక్స్ అమ్మ, ఇక్కడ విచ్ ఇస్ ఈక్వల్ టు 1 బై పి స్క్వేర్ యాజ్ ఇట్ ఈస్. ఇన్ ద డినామినేటర్ వీఆర్ టేకింగ్ అగైన్ మైనస్ పి స్క్వేర్ వీఆర్ టేకింగ్ కామన్. ఇది టచ్ కావడం లేదు, దేంతో రాయాలో తెలియలేదు. వన్ బై పి స్క్వేర్ వీఆర్ టేకింగ్ కామన్, దట్ ఈస్ విచ్ ఈస్ వన్ బై పి స్క్వేర్ ఎలా రాయాలో తెలియడం లేదు, మనకు అలవాట్లేదు కాబట్టి 1 by d square minus p square into x square which is equal to 1 by p square as it is into 1 by, in the denominator we are taking minus p square is common. In the denominator, we are taking minus p square. We have d square. Then we are taking minus p square is common. That is 1 minus d square by p square. D square by p square of x square. Next change. This is not, I don't know how to use this. Okay, we'll come to, we will use next. Again, I will share the screen. ఇక్కడ 1 బై 1 మైనస్ డి స్క్వేర్ బై పి స్క్వేర్ హోల్ పవర్ మైనస్ 1 1 by d square minus p square is 1. We are taking common minus p square, that is 1 minus d square by p square. P square, p square, that is minus 1 by p power 4 into, in the denominator, 1 minus d square by p square, it comes to the numerator, that is 1 plus d square by d, which is in the form of 1 minus d whole power minus 1 can be written as 1 plus d square and so on. 1 plus x whole power minus 1 formula is, 1 minus x whole power minus 1 formula is 1 plus x square plus x cube and so on. In place of x, we are having 1 minus d square by p square, that is in the form 1 minus x. It comes to the numerator, 1 minus x whole power minus 1, then 1 plus x square and so on. In a similar manner, in place of x, we are having d square by p square, that is 1 plus x means d square by p square plus
madam,
d square by p square
on,
whole square. Emma? Hello? Hello?
Madam, screen baga kanapaled, madam. Blink out on the yasa pota on, madam.
Zoom jesthan ok nimisham. Ippuduma?
Madam, alage undi madam. White color vasta undi, malla notes kanapadta undi, white vasta undi madam.
Avuna? Mala host share cheyala? Sare ok nimisham. ఇప్పుడు స్క్రీన్ షేర్ అవుతుందా? హలో,
ఇప్పుడు అట్లే కనిపిస్తుంది
మేడం. ఇప్పుడు కూడా అట్లే,
ఇప్పుడు కూడా అట్లే ఉందా?
అవును మేడం,
క్లారిటీగా లేదు.
కాదు మేడం,
బ్లింక్ అయి వస్తుంది మేడం, బ్లింక్ అయి వస్తుంది మేడం.
విండో తీస్తా ఉన్నాను, నెట్వర్క్ ఏమన్నా వస్తుంది. ఇప్పుడుమా
అలాగే ఉంది మేడం.
ఏం చేయాల? సరే, 1 బై డి స్క్వేర్ మైనస్ పి స్క్వేర్ ఆఫ్ ఎక్స్ ఉంది. 1 బై డి, ఇన్ ద డినామినేటర్ వీఆర్ టేకింగ్ మైనస్ పి స్క్వేర్ యాజ్ కామన్. అక్కడ ఎక్స్ బై పి స్క్వేర్ ఉండాలి. మా రాంగ్లీ రిటర్న్ హియర్, ఎక్స్ బై పి స్క్వేర్ ఉండాలి. దెన్ మైనస్ 1 బై పి స్క్వేర్ అవుట్ సైడ్, 1 బై 1 మైనస్ డి స్క్వేర్ పి స్క్వేర్ ఇంటూ ఎక్స్ ఉండాలి. దట్ ఈస్ మైనస్ 1 బై పి పవర్ 4. 1 మైనస్ ఎక్స్, ఇట్ కమ్స్ టు ది న్యూమరేటర్, 1 మైనస్ ఎక్స్ హోల్ పవర్ మైనస్ 1, దట్ ఈస్ 1 ప్లస్ ఎక్స్ స్క్వేర్ ప్లస్ అండ్ సో ఆన్. ఇన్ ప్లేస్ ఆఫ్ ఎక్స్ వీఆర్ హ్యావింగ్ డి స్క్వేర్ బై పి స్క్వేర్, దట్ ఈస్ 1 ప్లస్ ఎక్స్ అంటే డి స్క్వేర్ బై పి స్క్వేర్ ప్లస్ ఎక్స్ స్క్వేర్ అంటే డి స్క్వేర్ బై పి స్క్వేర్ హోల్ స్క్వేర్. Therefore, d square by p square whole square means d power 4 by p power 4. But d is the derivative of first function x. Aithe derivative of one time differentiate chese x derivative 1 avutadi. Alage second time derivative of x x value is 0. X derivative one time aithe 1. Another time differentiate chese 1 derivative ante 0. కాబట్టి డి స్క్వేర్ కి వాల్యూ 0, ఇట్ బికమ్స్ 0, బట్ నీడ్ నాట్ క్యాలిక్యులేట్ డి పవర్ 4. దేర్ఫోర్ 1 ప్లస్ డి స్క్వేర్ బై పి స్క్వేర్ ఆఫ్ ఎక్స్ మైనస్ 1 బై పి పవర్ 4 అలాగే ఉంది. 1 ప్లస్ డి స్క్వేర్ బై పి స్క్వేర్ ఆఫ్ ఎక్స్ వాల్యూ 1 ఇంటూ ఎక్స్ అంటే ఎక్స్ అవుతుంది. 1 బై పి స్క్వేర్ ఇంటూ డి స్క్వేర్ ఎక్స్, ఎక్స్ని 2 టైమ్స్ డిఫరెన్షియేట్ చేయాలి. దట్ ఈస్ ఎక్స్ డెరివేటివ్ ఈస్ 1, ఇట్స్ డెరివేటివ్ అగైన్ సెకండ్ డెరివేటివ్ ఆఫ్ 1 అంటే 0. దేర్ ఫోర్ సెకండ్ టర్మ్ డి స్క్వేర్ బై పి స్క్వేర్ ఆఫ్ ఎక్స్ టర్మ్ 0 అవుతుంది. దట్ ఈస్ మైనస్ 1 బై పి పవర్ 4 ఇంటూ ఎక్స్. ఓవరాల్గా అది మైనస్ ఎక్స్ బై పి పవర్ 4. నౌ ఇది is pi gaadu ma cf id cf value a e power plus px plus b e power minus px therefore solution y bar is equal to a e power cf plus pi we have to write the answer therefore y bar is equal to cf value a e power px plus b e power minus px minus plus pi value is minus x by p power 4 that is x by p power 4 now y bar value this is now given condition is y bar is equal to 0 at any value of x and r at any value of x given condition y bar is equal to 0 is given therefore both sides x k value aina ikkada ikkada x value 1 aithe y bar value em okka sari chudandi x value 1 kada okka nimisham given conditions x equal to 0 aithe then y equal to 0 0 equal dou y by dou t is equal to at t equal to 0 is given and y of 0 comma t value also 0 given y of 0 comma t means x value 0 x value 0 after substituting x value equal to 0 we will get y bar is equal to 0 therefore both sides x equal to 0 left side y bar is 0 is equal to a into e power 0 into a plus b into e power 0 that is b minus 0 therefore 0 equal to a plus b we have got since y bar equal to 0 for all values of x and given condition is there therefore y bar equal to 0 for all values of x and x a value aina y bar 0 that is a equal to 0 b equal to 0 we will get therefore ఇది గివెన్ కండిషన్ నుంచి వీ హ్యావ్ అప్లైడ్ మా దేర్ఫో వై బార్ ఇస్ ఈక్వల్ టు ఏ జీరో బి జీరో ఆఫ్టర్ సబ్స్టిట్యూటింగ్ ఏ జీరో బి జీరో వీ విల్ గెట్ వై బార్ ఈక్వల్ టు ఓన్లీ మైనస్ ఎక్స్ బై పి పవర్ ఫోర్ బట్ వై బార్ మీన్స్ ఎల్ ఆఫ్ వై వాల్యూ ఈస్ మైనస్ ఎక్స్ బై పి పవర్ ఫోర్ దేర్ఫో వై ఈక్వల్ టు మైనస్ ఎక్స్ టేక్ కాన్స్టెంట్ ఎల్ ఎల్ కమ్స్ టు ది రైట్ సైడ్ ఎల్ ఇన్వర్స్ ఆఫ్ వన్ బై పి పవర్ ఫోర్ బట్ వై ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు మైనస్ ఎక్స్ ఇంటూ L inverse of 1 by p power 4 which is in the form of L inverse of p power n plus 1 n plus 1 is 4 then n is t power n by n factorial formula is that is n value 3 t cube by 3 factorial which is y equal to minus x t cube by 3 factorial means 3 into 2 into 1 that is 6 this is the value y equal to minus x t cube by 6 similarly this is this problem is for homework just hint isthan chudandi solve dou y by dou t is equal to dou square y by dou x square that is y of x comma 0 is equal to 3 sin 2 pi x and y of 0 comma t equal to 0 that is equal to y of 1 comma t this is for homework already we have written but you have to you have to do this problem as homework no? This is in the same way of equation 5 problem sorry problem number 5 problem number 5 is dou y by dou t is equal to 3 dou square y by dou x square y of pi by 2 comma t is problem laga cheyandi ledhi idi kuda undi inkokati four problem la cheyandi similar to four problem I will explain briefly solve dou y by dou t equal to dou square y by dou x square given conditions y of x comma 0 is 3 sin 2 pi x y of 0 comma t is 0 y of 1 comma t is 0 therefore y of 0 comma t means x value is 0 and y of 1 comma t means x value is 1 its value is 0 both the values are 0 at x equal to 0 y of 0 comma t 0 y of x equal to 1 also y of 1 comma t 0 therefore solution taking laplace transform on both sides so taking laplace transform on both sides that is l of dou y by dou t equal to l of dou square y by dou x square that is py, L of dou y by dou t formula is py bar minus y of x comma 0, which is equal to L of dou square y by dou x square is d square y bar by dx square. That is py bar minus 3, y of x comma 0 value is 3 sine 2 pi x, that is equal to d square y bar by dx square. Now, a plus py bar comes to the right side. That is d square y bar by dx square minus py bar is equal to minus 3 sine 2 pi x. Now, this can be written as capital D square minus p of y bar is equal to minus 3 sine 2 pi x. Therefore, y bar is equal to cf plus pi. We have to write d square minus p of y bar is equal to 0 means that is f of d is d capital D square minus p. Therefore, auxiliary equation is m square minus p equal to 0. M square is equal to plus p. Therefore, m equal to plus or minus root p. Therefore, m1 is plus root p, m2 is minus root p. Therefore, cf is a e power root px plus e b e power minus root px. Then, pi is minus 3 sine 2 pi x by d square minus p. Now, which is a sin ax method. Sin ax method, we will substitute in place of d square minus of a square if it is not 0. Therefore, a value is 2 pi, d square place to minus of a square, and that is minus of 4 pi square value we have to substitute. That is minus 3 sine 2 pi x by, in place of d square, we will substitute minus 4 pi square. That is minus 4 pi square minus p. That is 3, in the denominator, we are taking minus common, minus minus plus. That is 3 sine 2 pi x by 4 pi square plus p. Therefore, particular integral is 3 sine 2 pi x by 4 pi square plus p. Therefore, actual solution is y bar is equal to cf plus pi. Cf value is a e power root px plus b e power minus root px plus pi value is 3 sine 2 pi x by 4 pi square plus p. Now, given conditions y of 0 comma t equal to 0, that is 0 is equal, x value is 0. Therefore, y of both sides we are substituting x is 0. Therefore, left side 0 equal to right side a into e power 0 into 1, that is a, plus b into e power 0 into plus b, sine 2 pi into 0 into sine 0. Sine 0 value is 0. Therefore, only first two terms, a plus b, that is after substituting y of 0 comma t equal to 0, that is equation 1. Next, y of 1 comma t equal to 0. Therefore, left side comma t is 0, y bar also 0. We are substituting x equal to 1 on both sides. So, therefore, x equal to 1 on both sides, y of 1 comma t equal to 0, left side value 0 is equal to right side a into e power root p, x ki 1 substitute chestunnamu, that is a e power root p plus b e power minus root p, that is equation 2. Solving 1 and 2, equation 1 is 0 equal to a plus b, equation 2 is a into e power root p plus b into e power minus root p. After solving 1 and 2, we will get a equal to 0, b equal to 0. Therefore, y bar is equal to 3 sine, first two terms 0, only 3 sine 2 pi x by 4 pi square plus p. Y bar means L of y is same term. Therefore, y equal to L inverse of 3 sine 2 pi x by 4 pi square plus p. In this term, 3 sine 2 pi x and 3 sine 2 pi x as constant. Therefore, y equal to 3 sine 2 pi x into L inverse of 1 by 4 pi square plus p. But 3 sine 2 pi x as it is into L inverse of 1 by 4 pi square plus p value is L inverse of 1 by p plus a. That is e power minus 80 value. A value is 4 pi square. That is e power minus 80 into e power minus 4 pi square t. That is y. Y equal to 3 sine 2 pi x e power minus 4 pi square t value. లెఫ్ట్ అవ్వద్దండమ్మా, నేను ఒకసారి స్క్రీన్ షాట్ తీసుకుంటాను ఈ మెథడ్ కన్యూషన్. సరే లెఫ్ట్ ఇవ్వండి మా, మాది రికార్డ్ చేస్తున్నాం ఒక నిమిషం, మళ్ళీ రికార్డ్ ఆపండి.
మటన్ చేస్తారా మేడం?
రికార్డ్ చేసి పెట్టమంటున్నారు, నాకేం అర్థం పెట్టలేము, దబదబా చేయలేము. సరే మా లెఫ్ట్ అవ్వండి.
ఓకే మేడం.
లెఫ్ట్ అవ్వండి.